Chief Matano. Chief Matano. It's about my daughter, Lillian. It's been 6 weeks now and I still can't get a call from her. And I've tried calling her London number, but I still can't get her.
Now, Agnes, eh? We're just coming from a funeral. Why don't you come to my office so that we discuss these issues in a more suitable condition?
But my daughter, Lillian, what if something has happened to her?
Okay, you do this. Go to my office and let me come and we see what to do.
So who does he think he is? Coming to interrupt people when we are discussing serious issues. Eh?
Hey, Margaret, I have to rush to my office. I have issues to handle, as you can see.
Chief Matano, I was telling you about my daughter.
Oh, yes, Lillian. So what is it?
You know, Lillian went to London with the family she was working with. At first, she used to call once every week, but for the past 6 weeks, I haven't had any call from her.
You said she went to work for the Martadias?
Yes, they're now back in Nairobi, but they didn't come back with her.
Why not?
I called the Martadias. They say she ran away. I'm worried. Where is she living? What if she's sick and she has nobody to help her?
No, she cannot stay there for that long. She went under what type of visa?
I don't know. But it's the family that she was living with that booked everything.
Now, you do this, eh? Give me the number of these Matathias. I think I'll need to give them a call.
Okay. Aren't you supposed to write the report in your book first?
Madam Agnes, now you want to teach me how to do my job?
At least that's what they do in the big city.
No one, just me.
Who's in town?
Who is the beautiful lady?
She's stunning.
Guys, I booked her.
What?
I booked her.
Lillian! Anna, that's my daughter. It's Lillian! It's Lillian! Lillian! Oh, my baby! I miss you! Oh, I can't believe it. Look at you! I miss you too. Thank you very much for your help.
You're very, very welcome. Now, good people, let us let Lillian go home with her mother. She has just arrived from London. And she's not had the best of time, as you'll soon find out.
I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to dwell on the past. I just want to move on.
But you'll only move on if you get it off your chest. Think about it.
Look, it's not that I don't appreciate your help, Chief, but I don't want to talk about what happened.
Do not talk to the Chief like that. He's the reason you came back safely.
I know, and I appreciate it, but I don't want to talk about the past. I need some space.
I had to sell them. After you left, things got so bad. We had to eat and your sister had to go to school.
Mom, you didn't have to do that. You could have found a way instead of selling all our possessions.
Hey, do not talk like that. You're part of the reason all this happened. I sacrificed all I had to get you abroad. Then you come back here to judge my actions.
So you're blaming me? Do you know what I had to go through to survive? Do you know what I went through? What? Do you have any idea? I did all that hoping that one day I could look after my family, and when I come back, this is the reception that I get.
I'm sorry, Lily. I'm sorry, I overreacted. I just felt awful that you couldn't realize what we had gone through.
I just never thought you would talk to me like those girls in the cyber.
Everyone is saying awful things about my stay in the UK.
They'll soon forget about it.
Mom, I've decided to come clean about my experiences. I'll accept the Chief's offer to talk about what happened to me. Maybe if that way I'll be able to live my life in peace.
Chief! Chief! I want to move on with my life. I don't want to live in the past, so I've decided to share my experiences.
Ah, Lillian, that's a very brave move you're making. I'm very happy that you've thought about it and decided for yourself.
I want to dispel the rumors.
What rumors?
People are talking about me. Everyone is talking.
When you tell them what happened, you'll not only be telling them the truth, but also denying them what to talk about.
I'll be there in the afternoon.
Good. Let me go and gather the people, then I'll see you later.
Okay.
She used to work at the McDonald's, then she was fired.
No. She was a waitress at a very expensive time. And then she quit.
Silence, please. Lillian here has just returned from the UK, where she did not have the best of experiences. My hope is that her story will open all your eyes.
You do even have an idea of what visa you applied for.
It's a visa, do I care? As long as I'm in the land of honey and milk.
Well, where is this Doji? He should be here, Doji. Anyway, Lillian did not return because she wanted. She had traveled to the UK on a domestic worker's visa that was provided by the family she had gone to work for.
It's really sad when you come back home expecting to be welcomed and instead people scold you. When you walk into a room trying to make friends and then people tell lies about you. It really hurts. I was happy to go to England. I hoped for greener pastures.
And?
Just let me finish. I had worked as a nanny for the family that had helped me go abroad. That worked well for a while until they had to return home. And so they passed me on to a different family. Life was good in the beginning, but after some time, I found myself doing odd jobs. I would work through the night and without even getting food. And if I did, it would be remains. One night, the father of the house came home drunk and found me sleeping on a bed. I was not allowed. He bit me. I couldn't take it anymore, and so I escaped in the night. I had to survive on the streets because I was afraid of going to the authorities now that my visa was invalid because of changing employers.
Oh, yeah.
I was lucky. I got a job as a toilet cleaner. Because I was an illegal immigrant and my visa was invalid, I was paid very little money, but I had no choice. And so I worked there for a while. It was hell.
How did you manage to return back home?
One night, the UK border agency staff were cracking down on illegal workers. They caught up with me as I was leaving work that day. That's when I knew things were really bad.
So what did you do?
Nothing. I surrendered. I thought they would arrest me, but the guys were really nice to me. They actually helped me come back here.
And how did they know?
Must have been computer records.
Does that mean you can't go back?
I am going nowhere. I am going to stay right here and help build this community. Life abroad is very expensive. If you can afford to live here, there is no point going abroad. My family has sacrificed so much so that I could go.
I thought you said that the family you are working for are the ones who paid for the visa.
Yes, they did. But my mother gave me her savings so that I could set up my life over there, but I wasn't able to send any money back, so they remained suffering. I am very happy to be home. I hope you can accept me back.
Let us all now formally welcome Lillian back home.
On Makutano, I explained how I traveled to the UK on a domestic worker's visa. But because I stopped working for the family that I traveled with, my visa became invalid and I was forced to work illegally. Life was difficult. Thankfully, the UK Borders Agency found me and helped me to return home. See you next time on Makutano.